update to breaking news we've been following this afternoon. Major developments in the case of a local Catholic priest accused of child porn.
Father Shawn Ratigan has been indicted on 13 federal charges. And KMBC 9's Micheal Mahoney is joining us now with the very latest. Michael?
Indeed, the grand jury charges indictment came down this afternoon here at federal court. They stem from a time frame of 2005 to as recently as April of this year. That would have been after the diocese was made aware of concerns about Father Shawn Ratigan when he was a priest up at St. Patrick's Church in Clay County. The latest incident, according to the indictment, happened on April 24th of this year. That's an interesting date, because that's Easter Sunday of 2011. All the victims in the indictment are young girls. They are ages of 2 to 12 years old. And some of these incidents, according to the indictment, happened not only on church property, but in one instance on the church steps, on another one, the church choir loft. And here's what the U.S. Attorney Beth Phillips said about the indictment handed down today.
On 11 separate occasions involving 5 different victims, he engaged in the manufacture of child pornography and the attempted manufacture of child pornography.
This is when I'm having a great deal of difficulty separating my own personal feelings from my role as an attorney. And I have to say, it just turns my stomach to know that those little children were victimized in more than one place and more than one occasion.
Father Ratigan remains in custody on child possession of child pornography charges in Clay County. The U.S. attorney here, Phillips, stressed that these indictments do not include any accusations of distribution of child porn, simply possession and production of it. That's the latest here from federal court. Back to you.
Thank you, Michael. Now, immediately following the indictment, we received a statement from the Diocese of Kansas City. In part, it says, the diocese expresses its profound concern for anyone who may have been harmed by Shawn Ratigan. Additionally, the diocese has pledged its continued cooperation with law enforcement representatives.